centimer, which is on chemistry. It will be on chemistry. Only two question, don't only 12, huh? You off like yes, 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 relax, relax, relax. Physics, 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 physics. Yes, 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 yes. So, guys, yes, you guys, you have the Chemon on this Sunday. Okay, so based on by what all things will be required for Chemon extra beyond motion. I have not included any question of motion today. Okay, motion is what you guys know. We have done good amount of questions and practice sessions over motion. Beyond motion, thoda bahut vector is also coming, right? Chota mota chin to tail. Okay, sure, clear. So today we are going through the questions which are today we are going through the questions which are today we are going through the questions which are from okay, 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 okay.
Sir, at what time is the Chemon test?
Beta, that will be announced thoroughly by Rohit sir. Okay.
Sir, vectors is coming for Chemon, right?
Yes.
Is that true and false today?
Repeat.
Sir, is that true and false today?
Sir, no, true
no,
and false.
No, no true and false. No true and false.
Options.
We
options
are thoroughly, yeah, we are thoroughly discussing about Chemon. Okay, Chemon scenario. Okay. So.
So, what is the topic for today?
Beta vectors. Okay. Good. So here we go to question number one.
Sir,
ready?
Sir, Dhruv is saying to wait for 2 minutes because there's a power cut in his area.
Okay, okay, fine, 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 fine. Theek hai, we'll wait for 2 minutes. Right? So vectors, 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 vectors. AI plus BJ plus CK is a vector. So in that scenario, what will be the magnitude of the vector? Quickly, over the chat. If AI square root, okay by Tanvi. A square plus B square plus C square. Square root A square plus B square plus C square. Very good. The magnitude of a unit vector is equal to. The magnitude of a unit vector is equals to. Beautiful, beautiful. You so guys you are aware about the scenario, okay? So R for ready. R for ready for the quiz. So everyone, R for ready for the quiz. R for ready. R for ready. Very good, very good. And here we go to question number one. Read, calculate, respond. The unit vector along I plus J is. Along is the word which is telling you that direction since. Okay. The direction should be along I plus J. The magnitude is what a unit vector should have. So epically easy. Wow. Good, 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 guys. So you guys will be finishing this before the allotted time, I guess. Good. 53, 54 people have responded. Still 20 seconds are remaining. It's going to be good. It's going to be good. It's going to be good. No trap. Relax. Easy calculation will lead you today, beta. As we are focusing toward Chemon, no trap, nothing, only learning, simple, smooth learning. Okay, see now. relax, relax, relax. This was the question. Okay. Now, for this question, bachas, really no chatting, etc. over the miscellaneous scenarios. Okay. Go, relax. The unit vector along. Now, beta, wherever there is a vector v, a unit vector along the vector is equals to the vector v divided by the magnitude of the vector. Now, for this vector, what is the magnitude? The magnitude of this vector is equal to square root 1 plus 1, 2. So, a unit vector along this vector will be this vector divided by its own magnitude. Easy, easy, easy. Relax. Good. Got it. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good.
So, answer C.
C, 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 C. Okay. Good. Leaderboard, 23 people only got it right out of 60 odd people present. Pooja, Dhruv, Prateek, Anuya, Parth, and Sriram. Very good, very good, very good. R&R champions are fulfilling the whole leaderboard. Good, 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 good. Chalo, here we go to the next question. Relax, read, and respond. I repeat, relax, read, and respond. A vector is represented by brr. Its length in the xy plane is. In the xy plane, only in the xy plane. Relax and respond. Relax, think, and respond. Relax, calculate, and respond. Good, Dhruv. Very good, very good, very good. No, there is no, I am promising you no trap. If you apply your concepts to the point, you will get a relaxed, correct answer. See, 25 people only, 19 and 11 and 10 people are deviated. Beta, please look, what is the scene? Only in the xy plane. Its xy plane part is this. What is its length here? Square root of 3 square 9 plus 10. Suppose they would have been asking only in the xz, then your answer is square root of 9 plus 4. Only in yz, square root of 1 plus 4. Got it? Good. On the other line, they can also ask, what is its length along the x-axis? 3. Along the y-axis? 1. Along the z-axis? 2. G-I. Got it? Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Leaderboard. 23 in the previous one, 25 in now. Same 25 people, I guess. Pooja, Dhruv, Prateek, Anuya, Rudraditya, Ahan. Good, good, good. The fastest one to respond, this was Monisha. Very good, Monisha Vache. 1, 2, and here we go to the next question. Unit vector parallel to the resultant of vectors A and vector B. Parallel to the resultant of vector A and vector B. Calculations will be required, which is directly showing in the type, like the wave of answers coming. Good, good, good. You guys are calculating. No, beta, it's not like just giving away. I am just like making your mind up good. Not like it's not about for very few people, right? It's about everyone. So as of now, instead of concentrating on the right wala bar, my concentration is on the wrong wala bars. There should not be any wrong wala bar. That's what my target is. Good response. Good. Very good. Very good. Very good. For clarification, please look here. Unit vectors parallel to the resultant of. The word resultant indicates addition of the two vectors. If no word is stated, they can also state a word parallel to the resultant of A minus B. That is a different scenario. But if they are saying only the word resultant, then it means addition. When you add the two vectors, I got added with I, which is 12i. J got added with J, which is coincidentally 5j. A unit vector is required. So divided by its own magnitude, you know this is a Pythagorean triplet, divided by 13 will be the answer. Bravo. GI. Everyone got it? Very good, very good, very good, very good, very good. Very good, very good. Please, okay?
Sir?
Yes, dear?
Why do we divide it by 13?
Because, beta, we did not need any vector. We need a unit vector. Okay? In order to create a unit vector out of any vector, our response was a vector which was 12i plus 5j, right? This is a vector, a healthy vector, but this isn't a unit vector. In order to make a vector a unit vector, we divide the vector by its own magnitude. Okay, the magnitude of these is 144 plus 25 in a square root. Square root 169, that is 30. Got it, bache?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good, good, very good, very good, very good. 39 people, good. Let's reduce the number of wrong bars more. And Dhruv did not respond to this, I guess, or he made a mistake. Prateek, Monisha, who is the fastest? Tarun is the fastest one to respond. Very good. And here we go to the next question. A truck traveling due north at 20 meter per second turns west and travels at the same speed. The change in its velocity B. The change. Very good. Now people are stuck. They are thinking. That's beautiful. Relax, read, calculator. Very good, Monisha. No problem, no problem. Relax, relax. See. Guys. Relax. First thing first, relax. This is the question. Okay. This is the question. Relax. How do you calculate change? That's why, right? How do you calculate change? That's what. How do you calculate change? How do you calculate change? Change, change, just change, change in anything. Final minus
initial. So final minus initial.
Very good, beautiful, bache. Very good, beautiful. So now, initial value was there is a movement toward north, right? 20 meter per second. Turns west, right? Clear? Fine. Good. Very good. Very good. Very good. Now understand here, what you have to do, this is vector final. Okay, I'll state it as final. And this is vector initial. You have to do final minus initial, right? Can you do final plus negative of initial? Am I clear with this line? Yes or no? Clear? Good. Can I say west plus south? Beta, final minus initial. Change has to be calculated. It is final minus initial. Right? Namrata, Namrata, Namrata. Change has to be calculated. It is final minus initial vector. Right? Sure? Clear? Now, final minus initial. Final minus initial. Final minus initial. Okay? Can be stated as final plus opposite of initial. Yes or no?
Why did you take minus I?
Beta, because it is saying na final minus. We have to calculate the change. So we have to check final minus initial. Okay?
Yeah.
So fine. Good. In that way, what you are doing, when this is changed to opposite, it will become toward south. Say yes. The same word, 20 meter per second. Clear? And their addition will go like this. Which direction is it? Southwest. What will be the magnitude? Square root a square plus b square plus 2ab cos 90. The value of cos 90 is 0. That will make this whole 0. 400 into 2 is 20 root. GI. Got it, guys.
So, can you explain this once more?
Yes, dear, please. No problem. You got this line, bacha? Point number one. Because we have to calculate change, we'll get final minus initial. Okay? Fine. Good. This can be stated as this. Okay? Fine. Final is toward west. Initial was toward north. So the opposite of it will be towards south. Easy. By parallelogram law of vector addition, if one vector is this way and one vector is this way, then their resultant will be along the diagonal. Who is along the diagonal? Southwest is along the diagonal. Got it?
So I didn't understand that.
Relax.
So how does it
why do we minus the west?
So how does it go southwest? How does that? How did you do the dotted southwest?
Okay, no problem.
So it should be northwest because it's traveling due north.
Rukja. Relax. It is going here north. 20 meter per second toward north. This is our initial vector position, initial velocity position. Then it turns toward west. And goes with the same speed, so it will make a square actually, right or not? Same magnitude. It is going toward west with 20 meter per second. That's the final. We are asked to calculate the change. The change is calculated by final minus initial. Okay, sure, no doubt. Good. Final is 20 toward west minus initial is 20 toward north. The problem is, if there would have been two vectors like vector 1 is equals to 2i minus j and vector 2 is equals to 3i plus j minus k type, and then it is asked me to subtract, then it is very easy for me. 2i minus 3i is minus I, minus j is minus 2j, and minus minus plus k. Yes or no? No doubt in this. But the problem over here is they are not in IJK format. They are in vector and direction, magnitude and direction format. And for them, we apply parallelogram law and triangle law of vector addition. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Right? Good. I stated you ki bhai, triangle law is applied when they are continuous vectors. They were continuous if they had to be added. When they have to be subtracted, this becomes plus, this minus goes in, it becomes 20 towards south. Any doubt? So the new operation we have to make is 20 west has to be added with 20 south. The resultant will be along the diagonal by parallelogram law of vector addition, and this direction is for pretty obvious reason southwest. Yes or no?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, dear.
So why did we subtract west?
Why did we sub? We did not subtracted west, beta. We subtracted north from west.
Yes, sir, but the option D is 20 root 2 meters per second south minus west.
So that's stating southwest, beta.
It's southwest.
Okay. Okay.
Direction southwest.
Okay. No problem. No problem. Acha, one thing is being noted over the chat. I never interfere into whatever fun we have in the class, but there is a particular word which is being used in order to tease someone. Whatever might be the background of it, that word should not be reflected again in the chat. Else, I'll make this quiz a offline quiz. How? You will only receive the mentee. I'll take myself out of the mock straw. Ready? That word should not be repeated over the chat. Okay? Very good. Thank you very much, guys. Sure. Can we proceed to the next question? Question number 5. All clear? So please remember, if there are vectors in the form of ijk, okay, you can add or subtract them without bringing any change. But if there are vectors in directions and magnitude separately given, then you will have to apply triangle or parallelogram law to add and subtract them. Especially while subtracting them, please be extra careful. G.I. Got it? Very good. Very good, guys. Very good. Good. Look into the leaderboard first. Anuya, Nishant, Harita, and the fastest one to respond is Nishant. Very good, very good, very good. Here we go to the next question. Good, guys. Good discussion. Healthy discussion is really favorable. The sum of two unit vectors is a unit vector. Again, then magnitude of difference is simple. It is given that A plus B is equal to something. Clear? Something 1. Then what is the magnitude of A minus B? Now this is a bit lengthy. It's a bit tricky. If you have responded it and got it right, beautiful. Beta, the number of seconds required to answer aren't surely unimportant, right? Good. Fourteen people only got it right. Very good, Shivam. Very good. Relax. We'll discuss it, okay? Okay, there is a unit vector V1. There is a unit vector V2. Their addition is coming out to be, if the sum of the two unit vector is a unit vector, is coming out to be another unit vector only. Then the question is, then the magnitude of difference is, what will be their difference? Okay. So, good. Now, for very obvious reason, we are not following the criterion of ij and k. We'll have to go and play with the magnitude scenario. Okay. When two vectors are added, their magnitude goes like magnitude of one square, which is one, magnitude of second vector square, which is also one, plus two into magnitude of first vector one, two into magnitude of second vector one into cos theta. This is given as one. Got this line y or n? Good, very good, very good, very good. Can we have no? Amit did not get it. Amit, beta, unmute. Amit, you know na, if two vectors have to be added by triangle or parallelogram law of vector addition, the magnitude of their resultant.
So Ahan, how did you get one?
But it is given that they are unit vectors. What is the magnitude of a unit vector? One. Right? So magnitude of a square one, one. One, one. Two into one cos theta is given as one. Is it still coming out to be a unit vector? Yes or no? Got it, dear friend? Got it or not?
Yes, sir, got it.
Good. So for this scenario, what is being stated is ki bhai, squaring on both the side, you will get 2 plus 2 cos theta equal to 1. 2 cos theta equal to minus 1. Cos theta equal to minus 1 by 2. Y or n, y or n, y or n. Good. And you know it very well. When they are being added, it is a plus. When they are being subtracted, it will become a minus a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta. We know this is minus 1 by 2. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Good. 2 and 2 got cancelled. Minus will make it minus 1, 1 and 1 square root 3 is the answer. Got it? Everyone got it? Everyone got it? Especially those who don't get it, beta, please. Good, 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 good. Relax. Ashish, relax. There is nothing difficult in Camon. Relax. Keep what is being taught in mind. That will be fairly sufficient. Okay, guys, moving forward. Leaderboard. So again, a good shuffle will be observed. Yes, good. Monisha is at the top rank. Good. Next question. The three vectors A, B and C form. Relax, take your time and calculate. In order to form an equilateral triangle, their length should be equal. Calculate their lengths. In order to make a right angle triangle, one of them should have a dot product equal to zero. Clear? The verification which you will use for an equilateral triangle will thoroughly work for a isosceles triangle. It can also be utilized for an equilateral triangle provided you get a Pythagorean triplet. That's why the best method of calculating this question is to calculate the magnitude of the three vectors. Tanya, that will be shown. It's a right angled triangle. Relax. Look here. Guys, again I'll repeat. You know what should be done with the question, right? The magnitude of A is 9 plus 4 plus 1. The magnitude of this is 1 plus 9 plus 25. The magnitude of this is 16, 20, 21. For very obvious reason, square this, and add, you will get this. So hence, it is a Pythagorean triplet. Got it?
So what? Can you repeat?
Repeat, beta. See, there were three vectors. Okay. We calculated the magnitude of all three, A, B, and C. We found that the magnitude of this is 14, the magnitude of this is 21, and the magnitude of this is 35, which is very valid proof that they are a Pythagorean triplet. 14, 21 is equal to 35. Yes or no? P square plus B square is equals to H square. G, I got it? Anyone having doubt?
Sir, another thing.
Yes, please. Welcome.
Sir, how do we prove it's an equilateral triangle if we have like three of them?
So that's why. The best method for proving anything is calculation of magnitude. Okay?
Yeah, then, I got it.
Yeah, the magnitudes will come, all three magnitudes will come same.
Equal.
It will be an equilateral triangle. Two will come same and they are not satisfying a Pythagorean triplet isosceles triangle. Else isosceles right angle triangle, right or not?
Sir, so if all three are different and then it doesn't
satisfy Pythagoras.
Right angled, then it's
no, not triangle. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sure. Good. Very good. Next question. And before that, leaderboard. Manisha is still playing good. Pooja, Harita, oi. Harita is the one. Okay, rest in peace, floor gang. This is someone from Indranagar. Sure, don't do that. Next question. If two vectors are parallel to each other, then the value of lambda is. Positive, negative doesn't matter as of now. Okay, the value of lambda is positive or negative doesn't matter. It should be in mod. Okay, the value of lambda is. Now it should be maximum, correct? Why? Please note this. If, note two lines. Line number one. For a vector pair, that is V1 is equals to A1i plus B1j plus C1k. And A2i plus B2j plus C2k. V1 is parallel to V2 provided A1 upon A2 is equals to B1 upon B2 is equals to C1 upon C2. Guys, very good, Namrata. Very good. You got only one wrong in this quiz. Very good. Okay. And then V1 is perpendicular to V2 implies that A1 into A2 plus B1 into B2 plus C1 into C2 should be equal to 0. Similarly here,
I don't think you taught INR this.
I remember.
He taught
I very thoroughly remember. Okay.
Oh, sorry.
2 minus 2. So this number into minus 2 should be equal to this. For very obvious reason, this is 1. So it should come as minus 2. Okay. It should be plus 2 here. Okay. That's why I use that word. Please ignore the positive or negative sign. The actual value of lambda should be, the actual value of lambda should be minus 2. Okay. Guys. Yes, Amit, I'll repeat, beta. Repeat, I'm repeating the line. Please remember. What am I stating? I'm stating that. I'll try a bit, thoda sa patla pen, okay? I'm stating that if there is a vector 1, 9, this is very bad. If there is a vector 1 and there is a vector 2 with A1, B1, C1 with respective I, j, and k, and A2, B2, and C2 with respective I, j, k, then vector 1 is parallel to vector 2 if they are proportional, like A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2 is equal to C1 upon C2. Similar. Two 2s are, three 2s are, so 1 2s are 2. It should become as 2. I stated that ignore the sign, positive or negative. Okay? Sure. Similarly, if they would have asked that they are perpendicular, then A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2. Okay? Sure.
Should so be could you please explain the name once?
Which one is a parallel or perpendicular? Both? Sure. They are parallel, then their coefficient should be proportional. A1 upon A2 should be equal to B1 upon B2 should be equal to C1 upon C2. And they are perpendicular, then the product, individual corresponding product ka sum should be 0. Okay, this output is coming by cos theta, that is dot product. This output is coming by sine theta, that is cross product. Okay, don't worry.
So how many questions do we have?
But in total, I had kept 12 questions for today. Okay. Can we proceed? Got it? Got it? Everyone got it? Everyone got it? Sir, I did not do this cos sign. Sir, if NAFL has physics center. Okay, Anush Beta. Please remind me, okay? Here we go to the leaderboard. Namrata was the fastest one and she is leading the scoreboard as well. And here we go to the next question. Vectors A and B are at right angle to each other when I just now told you guys. Yeah. Tsunami of answer. I just now told you guys. No mistake in this. Just now I told you. Perpendicular and parallel. Perpendicular is what is called at 90 degree or at right angles, just in case you don't know. Okay. Relax, relax, relax. Good. Oops. Guys, please remember.
So isn't it A?
No, beta. Dot product. I just not told you dot product. Okay.
Excuse
me,
sir.
A.
Oh. Sir, but then isn't the dot the same as A into B?
No, beta. There are two types of product. A cross B and A dot B are two different products.
No, but in math, we have dot is nothing but multiplication.
Relax.
Sir,
what
sir,
happened?
That's why we chose. Sir, I chose C thinking that it was multiplication.
So I chose A because you had written A A1 times A2 plus B1 times B2 plus C1.
So I told
if you remember, product and cross product is two different
things. Here I stated ki this A1, A2, B1, B2, C1, C2
dot product is
coming out of cos theta, which is determined by dot product. And then I said this A1 upon A2, B1 upon B2, C1 upon C2 is coming out of sine theta, derived from cross product. Please remember this now, okay? Please remember. What is the basic definition? I'm writing it over here, okay? What is the basic definition? Basic definition, okay? For very obvious reason, beta, vector A plus vector B are at 90 degrees. Their addition is not going to be zero, right? Neither their subtraction is. If this is their addition, this is going to be their subtraction, their cross multiplication and their dot multiplication. The dot multiplication will be equal to zero when they are perpendicular. Why? Because by the definition, dot multiplication between two vectors is magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta. The cross product between two vectors is magnitude of A into magnitude of B into sine theta. At theta equal to 90 degrees, cos will be zero, hence dot product will be zero. Theta equal to 9. Yes, beta, yes, please.
So this means that when somebody says that dot product of A and B is equal to zero, then that means that the resultant magnitude of the vector's product is zero.
Yes, the product of the two vectors, okay, will be zero. Okay, and that is
so the answer is D for this product. Question.
Scalar product.
So for sine, it will be zero or what?
Sine 90 is 1 meter. Okay.
So the answer is D then.
Answer is D for very sure reasons. Okay. Okay, everyone, beta, feel free to ask doubt. For the very same reason, I have kept less number of questions because I was aware that for particular question, there will be a longer discussion. Ready? All okay? Okay, and don't understood dot product. Understand, dear? For everyone, you might be a routine attender of my classes or might not. Relax. There was an age when it was told to you that 2 plus 3 is there. So count 2 and then count 3, 4, 5. Your answer will come out to be 5. Yes or no? You accepted that? Okay. This is the sign. Yes or no? Yes. Now, understand. Now, there is a statement being given to you. Bhai, if there is this sign between two vectors, then it means multiply the individual magnitude of the vectors and take the cosine of the angle between them. Okay, this is defined as dot product. GI, got it? Definition.
So the final magnitude is zero.
How it will be zero, I'll tell you. Relax, okay? Sure. See there. Now, suppose we are doing 4i multiplied by 2i. Clear? Two vectors are there. Okay? Sure. And they are being multiplied as dot. Okay? Sure. Then, your answer is magnitude of vector 1 into magnitude of vector 2 into cosine of angle between them. What is the angle between I and I? 0 degrees, very good. So what is cos 0? 1. So their answer will be straight 8. Got it? Okay.
Sir, do you know if INR has a physics class before Kemon?
If INR has a physics class before Kemon, tomorrow
yes,
is Friday.
Yes, tomorrow.
Okay, so sir, could you revise
yes,
the cost? This cost and sign.
If you remember our last class, I was rushing through things for
revision.
Yes, relax.
So more revision.
Yeah. More revision.
So tomorrow you can teach like a lot for revision.
Okay.
Yes, so you can start.
Guys. Everyone else is also here. Guys, got this? Different people were asking. Got this. Second line. Now suppose if we are doing 4i dot multiplied with 2k or 2j, for example, your answer will remain the same. 4 into 4. What is cosine of angle? What is the angle? 90 degree. Because the angle between x-axis and z-axis is 90. The value of cos 90 is 0. That will make this whole thingy as 0. And that is why it is said, when two vectors are perpendicular, their dot product will be 0. Got it?
So, everyone sir, then 4i into 2i is not equal to 4i into 2k.
No.
The vector
sure
of,
not.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. Good. Very good.
Sure. Excuse me, sir.
Yes, dear.
Sir, can we have physics class tomorrow? INR.
We do have a physics class.
Sir, full. Without breaks.
Okay, welcome. Okay. Sure. Next question. And before that, the leaderboard. Please mute. Someone has left it unmute. Karun MPS HSR9 was the fastest one to respond. Very good, Karun. Sriram is maintaining a good, healthy top position from quite a good number of questions. Monisha is fighting consistently with Sriram. And here we go to the next question. The angle between two vectors is simple, quick, and very healthy. Very healthy, very much based on what we were discussing at last. This is exactly like previous question or previous to previous question, the lambda wala question. To how many people will I have the 2-hour class tomorrow? Chalo, I'll do whatever best can be done on that line, okay? But it's not motivating for me if everyone wants physics. The case should be, have been the reverse. Yeah, sir, physics will be sorted. Don't worry about it. 25 people got it right. Understand, same thing. When you do dot product, you get I to I, it's 25. You get J to J, it's coming out minus 25. The total answer is 0. We just now stated, when dot product is 0, they are perpendicular. Got it, everyone? Good. Please look at the leaderboard. Oh, what happened? Neither Monisha nor Sriram. How come?
Sir, I realized 1 second after answering that I had answered wrong.
Oops, no problem, bache. Please.
Sir, in voted time.
Anirudh, good. Anirudh, very good, Anirudh. Okay. Here we go to the next question. See, definition is given. read it and then respond. Bhai, it is given, Nikita, it is given. Caught is reciprocal of time. It is given, definition. As a human, I stated caught. I could also stated like, tan theta is equals to 1 upon theta. Then also, defined, right? Relax. Look at the definition. That's why I said, yes, 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 Monisha. No problem. Twenty-nine people got it right. We have to still fight with 25, 5, and 8 peoples for the rights of where we are here. Let us see, it is given. Tan theta, okay, is equal to 1 upon cot theta. So, cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta. So, cot 30 will be equal to 1 upon tan 30. So, 1 upon tan 30 is like this. Easy.
So can you give us the values for tan?
Yes.
Yes, so we have only given for cos and sin.
Are yaar, I have also given for tan. Don't worry.
Sine, not
sine, cos, okay, and tan. Sine 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90. Sine is 0, 1 by 2. 1 by square root 2, root 3 by 2 and 1. Cos is 1, root 3 by 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by 2 and 0. Tan is the ratio of the two, 0 by 1, 0. 2 and 2 got cancelled, 1 by root 3. Root 2 and root 2 got cancelled, 1 by 1 is 1. Root 2 and 2 got cancelled, root 3. 1 by 0 or also stated as not defined. Yes, I'll repeat the explanation, Dhruv. No problem, beta. So, Dhruv, look here. It is given that tan theta is equal to 1 upon cot theta. Okay, which implies that cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta. So, if someone will ask us cot 30, we will say, okay, 1 upon tan 30. And we know tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So the answer is here. Got it, everyone.
Sir, can you just wait a second? I want to note
yes, down. Please note this down. Okay. Note these things also down. Like just now you realize that the reciprocal of tan theta is called cotan theta. The reciprocal of sine theta is called cosec theta. The reciprocal of cosine theta is called sec theta. This will also be of huge utility in the Camon. Should be.
Sir, I really want to know how you got all that, but I think it will become centum 1.5 over then.
No, but which all that? These yellow
sir,
ones?
Yeah, these values, how did you get them?
Acha, if you remember, beta, from our class discussions, I am finding it a known voice, okay? Yeah? But if it is an equilateral triangle, A, and full A, if you will drop a perpendicular, right, then this will become A by 2 and this will also become A by 2. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
For everyone, I'm saying. If this would have been an equilateral triangle, this was 60. If you'll divide it, this will become 30. Yes or no? And this is for very obvious reason 90. Yes, yes or no?
Yes.
Looking from here for Sokatoa, okay, we have sine of 60 degree is equal to yellow dot, yes or no, upon A. Now, what is yellow dot? By Uncle Pythagoras, A square is equal to A by 2 square plus yellow dot, yes or no?
Yes, yes.
So the yellow square is root 3 by 2 A. Can you see that?
Okay.
This is root 3 by 2 A. If you'll put it over here, you will get root 3 by 2 A. Already there is an A. A and A got cancelled. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2. Yes or no?
Yes, yes.
Looking from here, sine 30 will be equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Cancelled 1 by 2. Got it?
Oh, okay, okay.
Looking from here, sine 90 is opposite by hypotenuse. Now, what is opposite to 90 degree? Is hypotenuse. Cancelled 1. Sine 90 is 1. Got it? So likewise, okay. All those can be proved, okay?
Okay, sir, got it.
Sure. Yes, dear?
Sir, can you go back to the previous page where you wrote the formula like cos sec theta, cot theta? Yeah.
That will take a lot because I might have erased them all.
You can take a screenshot.
I didn't, so I need to go back to the page.
No problem. No.
I have that screenshot. I have that screenshot. No problem. I can send it later to Tanya.
No problem. Relax. Relax.
I have it too. I can put it on Logstra.
Just released here. Yes. Got it. Got it. Got it. Can we proceed? Next question. Relax, huh? Leaderboard. So now Monisha will be leading the scenarios. I guess if no one else is jumping up. Yes, Anirudh is the fastest one. Very good, Anirudh Nambia. Yeah. Let's move on to the next question. Read the definitions. Read the definitions. Read the definitions. It's an easy one, provided you read the definitions carefully. What happened, Suchir? You can't believe on your eyes. Anush? Yeah. Thirty-three people, but 17, 12, and 14 beta. Please look, you know this. But it is given that this is equal to this. It implies that this is equal to this. This is equal to this is only possible when sine theta is equal to cos theta. And by our very recent chart, 45 degrees is the answer. Yes? Good. Next question. See the leaderboard. Shivam, I'll try to just get this error corrected in me, right? I suddenly like.
Please explain that question.
Okay, okay, no problem. Beta C. What is stated is A, like secant theta is 1 by cos theta, and cosecant theta is 1 by sine theta. Now, if they have to be equal, then theta is equals to, now you know, if they have to be equal, these have to be equal, yes or no? And they are equal only when theta is equal to 45 degree. You remember, both equate to 1 by root 2 in that case. Yes or no? Okay. Your brains are very much old for anything, guys. Don't be worried.
Sir, I have to now paint one wall of my house with this sine theta cos theta on it, sir.
That's the better. State your experience in two words, please, quickly, so that we can move on to the next question quickly. No one is typing. Good, 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 good. No problem. Good, 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 good. Dhruv, brr was good. Good.
So you should read some of the smaller ones, so they're very funny.
According to science, fun and informative are the very safe ones. So that's why everybody picks that.
Chalo, next question. Target score in physics, come on. Out of 100, 100 marks ka physics will be there. 100 mark physics, 100 mark chemistry, 100 mark. Good, 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 good. 40 to 70. Chalo, good, good, guys. Good, 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 good. Are there people still calculating? No, I guess we should proceed, okay? Here comes the last question for you guys. Given that cos theta is 3 by 5, then tan theta and sec square theta, tan square theta minus sec square theta is equal to. Relax, guys. Relax, relax, relax. Last question. Right? Somewhere in discussions, I was aware, that's why I kept only 12 questions. Which are. Very good, Raghav. Chalo. See, mixed response. Look here.
So, what is the answer?
I'll show na, relax. Cos theta is equals to 3 by 5. This implies that if theta is here, 3 is here and 5 is here. Yes or no? So for very obvious reason, 4 will come here. Yes or no? Good. Tan theta will be equal to 4 by 3 and its square minus secant theta is a ulta of cos we just now studied. Okay, so will be 5 by 3 and square. Clear? So will be equal to 16 minus 25 by 9 minus 9 by 9 equal to minus 1. Okay, just for a knowledge, there are three identities in 10th grade. Okay, in 10th grade, not required here, in 10th grade, which are sine square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1, 1 plus tan square theta is equals to secant square theta, and 1 plus cot square theta is equals to cosecant square theta. Okay, they are surely and thoroughly not at all required in 9th grade. I'm telling you, I'm promising you. But just for the knowledge requirement part of it, I'm telling you. Okay, so that is required for understanding, because they are not required for vector kind of understanding. For the vector understanding, what you require is you, what you guys know, or what is at least has been dispatched to you. Yes, guys, please, someone was speaking.
Excuse me. How do you calculate sec?
Secant is ulta of cos beta, reciprocal of cos. So, our kaha is there, na? So, secant is HA. Okay?
Yeet.
So, good. Should not be repeated, whatever and whoever has done that. Okay?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, dear bachche.
Can you re-explain the meaning of cos, sine and cos, tan and sine and all with a reference to adjacent and hypotenuse and all?
Yes, beta. See, remember, simple. So, ka and to a. Sine is opposite by hypotenuse. Okay? Cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. So, for theta, this is opposite, this is adjacent. And the largest side is by default hypotenuse. Opposite, adjacent. So sine is opposite by hypotenuse. Cos is adjacent by hypotenuse. And tan is opposite by adjacent. Okay. So they have their respective reciprocals. The reciprocal of sine is called cosec. The reciprocal of cos is called secant. The reciprocal of tan is called cot. Okay. You can use these as a cheating for your CAM on, if at all required. Okay.
So vectors is there in NCERT?
Vectors for 9th NCERT is not there, beta. But as we will be proceeding toward projectile, we will need it. That is why it is taught to you. Okay.
Okay.
So, tomorrow I am also publishing a kind of single pager for whatever is required as a quick revision for motion as well as vectors. Okay. Tomorrow I'll release it. Okay, guys.
So can it not be a one pager and be a bigger pager?
Okay, it can be a bigger pager as well. But one pager will surely be enough. I know. Okay. Sure. So 23 people got it right. Let's see. Who is winning the scenario and show? And I guess this girl, Monisha, is going to win it. Congratulations, Monisha. Congratulations. Good. Very good. Thank you very much, guys. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Bye. Good night. Bye. Good night. Good night. Bye. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Vache. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Bye, dear.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Bye, dear. Bye.
Thank you, sir. Amazing quiz. Bye.
Thank you, dear. Thanks a lot. Bye.